Hello friends, here in this video, we will see what is meant by crack propagation. Now, for crack propagation, here I'll write down, it can be explained in the following three steps. The first one is crack nucleation. Next is crack growth. And at last we have fracture. So now we have three stages in which crack propagation can be understood. Crack propagation means the increasing of crack from a very small hole to a very high value. So in that there are three stages: crack nucleation, crack growth and fracture. So for that, here I'll explain the detailed explanation is as follows. So the first one is crack nucleation. Now, for crack nucleation, here if I consider an element which is circular in cross section, now if I consider an object which is circular in cross section, now what is meant by crack nucleation? In this, there is a small hole inside the element. And if I project this, here I am drawing the two views. So now, suppose this is the front view of the component, and here we have, suppose this is the top view and here is the front view of the component. Then in case of crack nucleation, at first there is a small cavity, a very small hole or a crack which is there inside a material. So crack nucleation, it means that the failure will begin at a small nucleus inside the material. So this is crack nucleation, that the material inside it, if we have a small hole or cavity, and when the load is applied externally to the material, then crack will start forming from this small hole which is inside, present inside. Next, crack growth. For that also, I'll draw the diagram and explain. Now, in case of crack growth, once the nucleus is formed, that is a hole is present, then the crack will go on increasing, that is, the cracks which are developed inside the material will go on increasing, and this is the direction of the crack. So it becomes large. Next, after that, again, if we go on increasing the load, now when the load is increased again, then the crack which is moving in the direction towards right, the cracks would go on increasing internally and it will reach up till there. So in case of crack growth, here I can write down that from the nucleus the crack grows along the direction which is perpendicular to the axis of the member. So from the nucleus, as we have seen in case of the crack propagation, the first step was crack nucleation. From this small hole, when the load is applied externally, failure will start from this nucleus and it will go on progressing, that is the crack will go on increasing in a direction, that is this direction which is perpendicular to the axis. Here is the axis of the member. So perpendicular to this axis, the crack is formed. Next, here I can say that more ripples or bubbles are formed inside the material in this stage, that is during crack growth, more amount of ripples or bubbles are formed and more cracks are developed internally. Next, there is fracture, the last term. Now, when there is fracture, cracks are developed throughout the material, and that material will break into two halves like this. This is the breaking of the material. It breaks into two halves. So at fracture, we can say that once the cracks are formed internally, then material can break at any given instant, and that breaking of the material is called as fracture. So in this video we have seen the crack propagation and how many steps are there in that crack propagation, along with the explanation of each of the terms.